Good morning. This is Sally Morgan, physical therapist, craniosacral therapist, and talented T-Touch practitioner for animals and people. This is Tristan. He's a corgi, and we're here for an episode of Conversations with a Corgi. And we've been having a lot of trouble with the ticks here in the last couple of days. I took them on a walk, fully cedared, and we were out where there's a lot of fields and a lot of dogs and a lot of weeds, and he had two huge ones on him, even though he was cedared. And there's one behind his ear right now that I have to get as soon as we're done with this. I don't know, the cedar is the strongest thing I have, so if that's not working, I think I'm gonna switch to the rose geranium and we'll go from there and see how that is. Although it's been, the high yesterday was like 35. I don't know why ticks would be out when it's 35. I don't wanna be out when it's 35. And we're still wearing sweaters, and we're about 2 weeks away from usually the first day of the year when I walk around in shorts outside. So that's coming, but I don't know when. So today, having seen a lot of people on Facebook the last couple of days talking about how sad they are and they have the COVID blues and blah, blah, blah. So I thought we should take a minute and think about some things you can do to cheer up. And hopefully people have the things they need in their house to accomplish these things. A lot of our mood, which is in the amygdala of the brain, which comes in to our things in the world, come to us to the amygdala through our five senses, of course. And so one of the things that we can do to enhance our mood or to change our mood is through smell. And smell is a wonderful thing. And if you have a diffuser and essential oils in your house, this is the time to use them. If not, you might have things like the actual items from these things I'm going to show you in your house. So the first one, which is a really good mood enhancer, is lemon oil. If you don't have lemon oil in your house, you might have lemon extract, you might have an actual lemon. And you can cook that lemon, you can cut it up into slices with the skin after you wash it thoroughly and boil it, and it will make your house smell lemony, and then you can drink that lemon or add it to your tea and make it more lemony, or you can use it as a marinade for something you're making for dinner. But lemon to me is one of the most uplifting smells to change your mood, and I wouldn't live without it. And we all perhaps, if we're old enough, remember the Lemon Pledge Very Pretty commercials when you're spraying Lemon Pledge in your house. It's warm here. It got to 77. Ugh, we're still at the best in the 60s. Well, and Danny's in South Dakota. There's hope for us. Anyway, Lemon Pledge, probably when they put lemon in it, it wasn't just because we like the smell of lemon. Lemon does make you happier. And Lemon Pledge smells very lemony, like really lemony, not like fake lemony. And I think that the people who put the lemon smell in there were pretty smart, because the more happy you are when you're using it to dust, the more you're gonna wanna use it. So you're gonna buy more Lemon Pledge. So it was very smart to put the lemon tree, lemon smell in the pledge. So no accident. So find some lemon in your house. If it's lemon extract, you might make yourself a little lemon loaf, or like I said, just take a lemon and boil some pieces of it, and it will make your house smell lemony and it will make you happier. And closely related to the lemon are the other citruses. This one's tangerine, but you can also do the same thing with oranges, orange extract, tangerine extract. You can smell. One thing, if you don't have a diffuser, that I've done sometimes way long ago, is put out a bowl of water with just a couple of drops of, like a slim flat bowl of water, you know, not like a big giant salad bowl, with just a couple of drops of the oil on it, or even the extract, and that will help it get through the house. Another thing that people find uplifting, for me it's not as much so, is peppermint oil. And of course, peppermint isn't as hard to come across. You know, a lot of people have peppermint candy in the house. I have tons of peppermint growing in my garden, which even the broken up winter stems smell plenty pepperminty. And I have a few here behind me that are pretty much ready to go outside if it would stop snowing and being 20 at night. But mint can really improve your mood, and a lot of people that do all natural cleaning products will find that many of those are scented with peppermint. Again, for the same reasons that the Lemon Pledge was. It makes you happy, you want to clean more, and it's a better process. And most people like the smell of peppermint or spearmint or regular mint. And when they smell it in their kitchen, it feels clean and it feels good. One of the mood enhancing smells that I love, and it's less well known that it is actually a huge mood enhancer, is the smell of bergamot. Bergamot is what is in Earl Grey tea. So if you're feeling really sad, make yourself a cup of Earl Grey tea, or just go open the box of the tea bags and, you know, inhale deeply. But making a cup of Earl Grey tea can really lift you up. And I think any of my corgi and Cavalier and Jack Russell and other British breed viewers, Border Collies, will appreciate the fact that the Queen has a cup of Earl Grey tea Twinings every afternoon. And this is a traditional time to drink Earl Grey tea, in fact, because of its mood enhancing properties. Because, you know, we all know this. You've been at work, you had lunch, you plunge on through, and around 2:30, you're hitting that wall. You want to take a nap more than you ever have wanted a nap in your life. And that's, you know, 3 or 4, 2 is about when you would have that cup of afternoon Earl Grey tea. And it uplifts you, it makes you feel positive, it makes you feel motivated, and helps you get through the rest of your day at work. From California. Oh my gosh, Sue Bunny Lady's watching. Tristan, do your rabbit impersonation. So what are some of the other senses that you can change your mood with really easily? Hearing. Look around your CD collection. For some people, listening to peaceful kind of Reiki session music, New Age music, and you can even get this on your television set under soundscapes for most people with cable. And that kind of music for some people is relaxing, not necessarily uplifting. For me, uplifting music is dance music. When I hear that bass and the vocals, or even going back to like disco music or Donna Summer's music, music like that makes us happy. It brings us back to a nostalgic time. One of the things they've studied heavily is memory in people with Alzheimer's. And one of the things they found is that if they set up their environment to a time when they were functioning well, for instance, pictures of things in the 50s, having, you know, the snack bar be set up like a 50s soda shop, and listening to music from the 50s, maybe for World War II vets or Korean vets, will bring them back to a different time, and it will enhance their memory and they will function better. So we may think it's cute and quaint to go to a nursing home and see these nostalgic touches from the 30s, 40s, and 50s, and one day it will be the 60s. But it really is a very careful plan to help people function as well as possible. So find the kind of music you like that makes you happy. It might be dance music for you. It might be old Motown hits. It might be, you know, anything in your CD collection, you know, Bon Jovi, Bruce Springsteen, nostalgic stuff. Don't get the ones that are bummers, but play that music and smell the bergamot, peppermint, orange, or lemon that you have found in your house. And then the other thing you can do is change how things look. You can rearrange things in your house just a little bit. I mean, some people find this more fun than other people. Some people find it to be a lot of work. But for instance, plants. Plants release oxygen into the atmosphere and suck up carbon dioxide. They're our best friends, aren't you? They make my air better and I make their air better. It's a great symbiotic relationship. So I suggest if you have some plants in your house, you know, most people have one or two, but rearrange them and put them in a little area all together so that you have a bit of a jungle to sit in and breathe in that oxygen. And if you don't have plants in your bedroom, think about putting some in your bedroom for a few days. Because it does, of course, you don't want to put them there if they're going to die because there's no light in your bedroom, but it does really help you breathe because the plants are emitting oxygen. And in fact, snake plants, hate their name, love the plant, are famous for being called bedroom plants because they indeed release more oxygen at night than during the day. And as much as they are just these like thick sort of aloe type leaves, they really put out a lot of oxygen, and you're supposed to sleep better if you have a snake plant in your room. So we've looked at things to smell, things to hear, and things to look at. You can go further and look at things like taste. However, taste is really related to smell. And anybody who has watched any house shows or ever been a realtor or ever bought a house knows that you can make the house smell like home by putting in an apple pie in the oven or making some chocolate chip cookies or things like that, because it makes you remember things that were happy when you were cooking with the kids or your grandmother. And so you feel like that house is home and it's more welcoming. And you can do the same thing for yourself. But I would suggest you make something like lemon bars or lemon cookies, because that's going to really be uplifting, as opposed to something else that you might make, like that's more cinnamony. Chocolate is also uplifting. It releases a lot of happy neurochemicals in your brain, and so making some brownies might be a good thing too. But don't let that interfere with your personal smell therapy you've got going. Somebody says Star of Bethlehem Bach flower essences help a lot. That is true. That's another one that's uplifting, and it's a really light white flower kind of smell. And you don't have to diffuse these into your whole house. You can just put, especially if you're using like extract from your cooking supply, you can just put a little drop of it, you know, on the end of your nose and you'll smell it, or on your body in some way. And it will help uplift your mood. So think about some of these things you can do to bring new information to your senses and make you cheered up. And we didn't talk about the sense of touch, but all of the people listening to me have a pet. And so you can get that sense of companionship and relationship with your pet. So put your pet on your lap, sit next to your pet, put your pet's head on your lap. Just connect with your pet. I mean, a lot of dogs aren't that snuggly and you can't really hug them. And the same is true for cats. But you can, you know, like Tristan, I could go somewhere and hold his paw for like an hour. He would let me do that. A lot of dogs won't let you do that. But he's pretty snuggly in a lot of ways. So use your pet to really influence your sense of touch and companionship. And these things can help us cheer up at a time when a lot of people are feeling sad. So thanks for joining us today for this episode of Conversations with a Corgi. Everybody have a great day. Be happy. You can always listen to that song, Don't Worry, Be Happy. Whatever music makes you happy, listen to it when you're feeling down, or at least once a day, and it will actually help you get through this situation. So thanks for joining us today. We'll be back tomorrow with another episode of Conversations with a Corgi. We have a date with a tick right now. Thanks for joining us. Everybody have a great day. Corgi in your lap right now. Lucky Neely.